Thank you for tuning into Court TV. This is Fiancé Files. Today on Fiancé Files, it's the Cope Canuchari wedding. It's the meeting of the two. How did they meet? What are the circumstances? There's drama, there's tears, and there's happiness. Just tell me how Chris and Abby met, how they come to like meet each other.
Yeah, I remember it very well. Chris and I were up in Syracuse. It was a Saturday, and as we always did on Saturdays, we were at the soup kitchen.
Chris was actually in Syracuse, working at a soup kitchen. I guess that was a good thing to do.
He was doing really well in the soup kitchen. In fact, all of
it doesn't sound like something he'd do. I mean, why?
It's actually right up his alley. It was very fitting for Chris. He found his niche. I think that might be his calling.
He wasn't forced into doing it, the soup kitchen work, or?
Well, he was forced. Chris got in trouble with the law a little bit.
Yeah, I went to visit Abby up in Syracuse at her dorm, and it was so crazy. Craziest weekend ever. We were out, we were partying, and we were asleep one night, and all of a sudden the fire alarm started going off, and people are running around like crazy.
We were walking home, and I remember it very clearly because Chris was helping an old lady across the street, and he turned and saw the smoke coming from the building. And it was a Syracuse dorm room that was on fire.
And he looked up and saw on campus that there was a burning dorm. A room was on fire. And so he rushed in and heroically grabbed Abby, got out of there.
And everybody said, and even the firefighters said, don't go in that building, that's gonna come down. And he rescued dozens. I they're too many to count.
Yeah.
He ended up going all the way up to the 18th floor.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and that's where he found Abby.
It was at this point that I realized the story may not be true. I had to find somebody that would know the truth. That was when I discovered Chris's grandmother, Skinny Atlas, New York. We sat down just after dinner.
My grandson, he's a very hero because he saved his girl from a burning building. There she was up there, and he just went there and got her out, and I don't know what else he did. I don't remember.
I was disappointed to see that the grandmother was in on the secret, too. I assumed, because she's Sicilian, they keep the family secrets close to their heart. I had to go someplace else.
Heroically grabbed Abby, got out of there, and I think that's when she really met him and loved him from then on.
Mark, I don't know where that story came from.
What?
Where'd you hear that story?
From you.
Oh, I didn't tell you that story, Mark.
What?
That's not exactly how Chris went.
And how did it go?
Abby. Well, actually, Chris was attending Ithaca College at the time. And
my brother's not a hero?
Well, he's a hero, but he just didn't, this just didn't happen. That
I thought he was a hero! What?
Mark, it's gonna be okay. I mean, it's fine.
It's not.
I mean, Chris is whoever you want him to be. I mean,
he was my brother. He was the hero.
I don't.
So because of the broken heart of one young brother, I had to find, for his sake, the real story. Why was there such a tangled web of secrecy?
You may have heard a lot of lies in this tale, but I'm going to tell you the truth. The story goes as such. Chris never worked in a soup kitchen. Never. And if there was a fire, he'd be the first one to run out.
After the groundbreaking interview with Christopher's mother, I knew the parents were the key to finding out the truth. The destination, Boca Raton, Florida, JetBlue.
My name is Alex Cope. I'm Abby's brother. I guess one of my earliest memories of her would be the fights that we got in and her fake cry that would try and get me in trouble.
Abby's brother only chose to speak of the past.
I met Abby when she came home from the hospital. I was 2.5 years old, and I was very excited to have a playmate. Turns out Abby likes to play by herself.
Abby's sister, too, seemed to deny the truth. I had to find her mother.
Do you know how they met? Something about how he ran into some burning building and saved her life.
I heard a different story. You know, Chris had heard a lot about Abby, and a lot of discussion and stuff. He decided he wanted to get to know her. So he went on the line and found her.
So they lied.
They created a story that they thought people would accept.
After the mother had broken the awful truth to the siblings, they feared the worst, revealing the truth to the father. I sat down with them just before dinner.
What happened?
Well, what do you know about Abby and Chris and how they met?
Well, we owe Chris a real debt of gratitude. He saved Abby from that burning building.
Well, that's not exactly how it happened.
They exaggerated the truth a little bit.
What do you mean?
Well, they kind of met on email. I mean, they were writing back and forth and discovered they had a lot in common.
And he convinced her, based on that, to come up to Ithaca?
Yeah.
This guy's got to be pretty persuasive. Abby wouldn't fall for just some cockeyed scheme. That would have to be pretty well
yes,
written. That's impressive.
So you're not upset?
No, I think that's a much better basis for a relationship than being saved out of a burning building.
Well, there you have it. The Cope Canucciari wedding. The truth behind their meeting. Though a little boring, email and the like, there's no hard feelings on either side of the fence. Might want to tune in next week to Fiancé Files when we feature Joel and Melissa. Melissa is concerned with her fiancé because he likes to wear dresses. That's next week on Fiancé Files.